Center is available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week at 505-564-9192 or 888-440-9192. KSJE is supported by San Juan Regional Medical Center, whose vision is to deliver world-class care, making life better for the communities they are privileged to serve. Offering a comprehensive range of inpatient, outpatient, and emergency care services so residents can live life better here. San Juan Regional Medical Center, community owned and operated, here for you. Thursday morning here on KSJE. We have an extra segment for you this morning, which is talking to some of the theater students from Piedra Vista High School. They are now joining me here in the studio to talk a little bit about their upcoming performance of Dirt, which we'll learn more about as well. But joining me here in the studio, let me get the camera on so we can see all three of them at the same time. There they are. We have Chris Fiersick is here. Good morning to you. Thank you for coming in. Also, Abigail Gladden is here. Good morning to you. And Rose Durrett, good morning to you. Thank you all for coming in this morning, and you are all part of the cast of Dirt. And so talk to me a little bit about what this play is about. Abigail, let me start with you.
So it's about a family in the Dust Bowl just trying to get by, and it's like the Great Depression era, and so it's really hard for this family to just live and get by safely. And it's just them going through their life and, yeah, just trying to live and just...
Okay.
Yeah.
So a lot of other layers, I guess, maybe, to what's going on for this family, besides just economics and living in the Midwest, maybe, where things aren't growing as well as they used to be, and some of these other types of challenges, I guess, right, with this family? How big a family are we talking about? Is it a big family?
There's 10.
That's a big family.
There's 10 people in this family.
Okay. All right, very good. And so talk to me a little bit about, we have some photos of some of the rehearsals here. So is this the whole cast or part of the cast? What are we looking at?
It's the whole cast except my character.
Okay, you're not there.
But I'm being added into it now, but that was for our state performance. That's how we had it arranged, but we didn't perform that scene at state.
Gotcha.
Because it was too long.
Gotcha. And Chris, what's your character? Talk to me about your character then.
My character's name is Alvis, and I'm her character's stepdaughter, or stepson.
Okay.
Stepson.
Right.
My mother died when I was younger. And I have schizophrenia, so I cause lots of problems for the family and stuff, but I have, like, redemption towards the end of the play.
Okay, don't give it away. don't give it away. But there you go. Okay, very good. And Abigail, talk to me about your character.
So I'm Edith Lofton. I'm the mom of the family, and the whole play, like, it feels like for my character, she feels like she just keeps getting pushed down and things just keep happening. She's just trying to keep her family afloat. She's just trying to get her family by, and she feels like things just keep happening, but she's trying.
One thing after another is
one
coming
thing after another.
Okay, got it. Very good. Okay. And Rose, what about your character? Who are you playing in the play?
So I play Miss Buchanan, and I'm more of like the townspeople. All of us are there looking at another perspective with the Loftons. And we just are always there for them when things happen. Like, there's a breadline scene, and, you know, we're all just there as people there for the Loftons.
Right. Understood. And so, yeah. Because, again, during the Depression, everybody was kind of suffering together. It really wasn't that there were haves and have-nots. I mean, a lot of folks were really being impacted by the economic times of that period, correct?
Yeah.
So that's what you are dealing with. And so what's going on? This is a rehearsal picture, or?
Yes.
Okay. And so.
That is during, I don't know if you want a spoiler or not.
I don't want a spoiler.
Okay. If I explain that scene, it'll kind of like spoil a little bit.
Okay. Then we don't want to do that. That's okay. But we'll just take that.
It's an important scene.
And very important scene.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. Got it. All right. How about this scene? What's going on here?
It's the same scene.
Oh.
Right?
Is that the same scene? That's the bread line.
No, that's not the red line scene, but...
Oh, yeah, it's the same scene as last time.
Yes,
but
it's a very important scene.
It's
a very emotional scene.
Okay.
Yeah.
Gotcha. All right. Very good. And learning and being in this play, I mean, it seems like you guys are learning a bit about maybe American history with the Dust Bowl and some of these other issues and the Depression and other parts of history that come into this story.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we did a deep dive kind of before our play started on like the history and especially like the Great Depression about kind of like farming, especially because that's what our family does. We farm, and so... We were focused on learning about farming and what caused the Dust Bowl and kind of what was happening around that area. So we were very sure to kind of make sure we did our research.
Right, right. That's important, as any actor should do, right?
Yeah.
Do your research. So that's also important. I asked you all before we came on the air about your future plans, if they included acting. And for some of you, yes. For some of you, maybe not so much. But Chris, you were telling me that maybe you'll still... dabble a little bit maybe in theater, but it's not that maybe you're going to be your major in college.
Yeah, it's not going to be my major, but I do maybe plan on like kind of doing some theater related things throughout college and maybe a little bit after college.
Right.
But probably not like in school theater, probably just like the stuff that they productions that they do outside of school.
Community theater maybe, or things like that perhaps. So
yeah,
very good. Abigail, what about for you? Is it something that I think this is something that you really enjoy and maybe will continue to study, huh?
Yeah, I want to continue it in college, and I definitely love acting. It's a way for me to express myself, and I want to continue it for sure.
Right. Is there a favorite part that you've had that you really relate to? Is it this one, or is it some other play that you've been in?
I would say I really resonate with this character. I think the way that she tries so hard to just look out for her family, and the way she acts, she's stern, but she's caring. And I think it's a very... what's the word I'm thinking of? She's a very complicated character.
Right.
And I think I really, like, resonate with just how hard she works.
Right.
Yeah.
Strong-willed, I guess, maybe?
Yeah,
would
very
you think?
Strong-willed.
Right, okay. Very, very good. And Rose, what about you? What are your plans with theater?
I definitely want to continue it, but maybe just not, like, the main thing I want to do after college. I think it's something that I want to do as a side. Because I really love theater and I don't want to stop doing it.
Right, right. Very good. What about this picture? Let's see what's going on here. This is, again, pretty full stage. And who can describe what we see here?
So,
go ahead.
The people in the background are the ensemble. Mm-hmm. They're, like, not actually in the scene. They don't do anything in the scene except, like, some of them are, like, the one behind the girl in the center, the one that's wearing the hat. She's the priest, but she's just holding plates, so she's mm-hmm. like a cabinet or something.
Gotcha.
It's like plates and stuff that has our food on it.
Mm-hmm.
But it's just kind of like a dinner scene, and then something does happen towards the end of it, but it'll be another spoiler, so I can't really say
anything.
We don't
want to talk about that. Okay. All right. No, I don't want to spoil the show. And and here's another scene around the table.
So yeah, that's the family.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, that's the family... minus me and the father, but he's kind of just like out of the frame. But he's in the scene, but he's just not in the frame.
Gotcha. And you're off doing something, who knows what.
Yes.
Yeah, right. Got it. Okay. Very, very good. And here's another kind of wider shot of the family, I guess, too?
Yeah, that's the whole family, just not me.
Okay. All right. Very good. And so this play, it's going to be performed, tomorrow night is opening night, right?
Yes.
Yeah. How about that? So tomorrow night and then on Saturday... just two nights. Mm-hmm. We only have a chance to see it two nights at 7 o'clock.
Yes.
Up at Piedra Vista High School, right?
Yes.
All right. Very good. And so this is the first play of the school year, or have you already done something?
This is our first play of the school year, but yes.
Mm-hmm. And you'll do more?
Yeah. Yeah.
Is
so
the
we
plan?
Still have like our directing shows and our children's
spotlight.
Show. Yeah, our five-minute spotlight where all the intro theater kids will put on a performance. I think the next one we're really excited for is our children's show that we're doing.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what's that one about? Do you know?
It's Finding Nemo.
Yeah.
Musical.
I've heard of that.
It's like the Finding Nemo Junior musical.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
And so there's some singing and dancing, obviously.
Oh, yes.
Maybe on stage swimming. perhaps.
I think so, yeah.
You never know, right? Okay, very good. Well, I really appreciate you all coming in to talk about this play. We're just about out of time, but it sounds like you're all having a great time during the rehearsals and performing. Again, opening night is tomorrow. The play is on stage at the Piedra Vista High School Theater Friday and Saturday night, 7 o'clock. It is called Dirt, and folks can check it out. Tickets are available at the door, I would assume, right?
Yes, yes. $5 yes. a person.
Okay.
Yes.
Very yeah. good. Great. Thank you all very much for coming in.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for having us.
You're very welcome. My guest this morning from Piedra Vista High School with me on KSJE.
The moon belongs to